Okay students, in this video we will see that how to find whether a compound is soluble or not. It is little hard when we see a particular compound and determine whether this one is soluble or whether this one is going to form precipitate or not. So by this trick method we will learn whether some compound is soluble in water or not. Okay, so you can see in the left upper side we have compounds which will always be soluble in whatever they are mixed. Means the if you are focusing on the NO3, so if this NO3 is forming compound with any other element, that may be NaNO3, that may be okay ZnO3, ZnNO3 ka old twice, all these will always be soluble. So learning trick is upper side, you can say you can see that NaAg, NaG representing N with nitrates, A with acetates, and G with group 1 elements situated on the leftmost corner of the periodic table. Okay, so compounds forming with these three compounds or elements will always be soluble in water. Now in the left side bottom we have compound also with sulfates, ammonium, and group 17. That means all the compounds which are formed with sulfates, ammonium, and group 17 will always be soluble, with some exceptions which is determined with the asterisk that is on sulfates and group 17 with the magenta color and a green color asterisk on the sulfate. Now describing these asterisk, that is in the left side you can see the asterisk magenta color is on sulfates and group 17. On the right side this asterisk is defined that these are the exceptions. That means these elements are going to form the compound with left side sulfate and group 17, so they are going to be going not to be soluble in water. Okay, so these are PMS. You can learn by the word PMS. Okay, P represents for lead, that is Pb2+, M represents for mercury, that is Hg22+, and S represents for the silver, that is Ag+. Okay, so what I am saying, if lead is forming compound with the sulfate or maybe the elements of the group 17, taking example lead as a PbSO4 lead sulfate or PbCl2, PbBr2, PbF2, so all these are not going to be soluble in water. Now mercury forming, or silver, if silver is forming compound with sulfate, that is AgSO4, Ag2SO4, or AgCl, AgBr, so these are also not going to be soluble in water. Now moving right side bottom we have the word castrobium. This is representing Ca2+, Sr2+, and Ba2+. Okay, so if these elements, that means calcium, strontium, and barium, are forming compound, since you can see the castrobium have a asterisk of green, okay, and this asterisk is defined by left side bottom this compound sulfate. Okay, so if sulfate is forming compound with castrobium, that means calcium, strontium, or barium, with any one of these three elements, so the compound made will not be soluble in water. Okay, so I'm saying CaSO4 will not be soluble in water, SrSO4 will not be soluble in water, BaSO will not be soluble in water. Except these members or these compounds, all the rest are all soluble in water. Okay, thank you.